Hi, this is Jacqueline. I am here with MAPS Part 2. If you have not seen my first video on MAPS Part 1, please check it out as this video is a continuation of that video. So before I start, today, 12/12, marks my 1 year Covidversary. So definitely a lot of emotions today, a lot of post-traumatic stress, which I'm sure a lot of you feel when you kind of come up to that 1 year mark of still dealing with this virus and all the effects of it. This was when my first infection, and it just sort of sent off a cascade of a lot of other things and a lot of trials and tribulations that I've had to deal with over the last year. So please, if you have not checked out those videos, I definitely go through the entire timeline of everything that got me here to today, 12/12 of now 2021. Getting back to MABS, again, I had the BAM infusion on October the 5th. That was my first monoclonal antibody infusion. I do document all the side effects and everything associated with that in my first video. But basically, when I got to about the fourth week mark after BAM, I started to feel the symptoms return. I had a night where I had night sweats, which there is a doctor that believes when we have night sweats that means that there is some viral activity happening. And when I woke up that morning, I definitely could just feel that feeling that the virus was back. It's very hard to explain, but I felt that persistence of the virus. I'm dealing with more GI issues, so I felt like I just did not have an appetite at all, and kind of the abdominal cramping and just that feeling, that just off feeling, and also an irritability and an agitated feeling. So I immediately went and had a concierge service come to my home. And at that point I did a dose of Regeneron, and they also offered an IV bag and they offered anti-inflammatories. So when I felt that return of symptoms, which was, I started to feel that on a Friday, by that Sunday, I went ahead and had another infusion. Without a doubt, I started to feel better almost immediately. Within the next few days, all of the GI symptoms just all completely calmed down. The side effects that I had from Regeneron was I felt some head pressure, and I definitely felt a little worn out and just a little bit drained. I personally believe that Regeneron is better for the Delta infection, and that was my July infection. And I believe that a lot of the issues I'm dealing with now are from that second infection. I have no scientific data to back up which monoclonal antibodies are better with what strain, but anecdotally, what seems to be happening is people that have had the earlier strains are responding better to BAM, and some of the later strains, especially the Delta variant, seems to be responding better to Regeneron. I didn't have the same side effects at all with Regeneron, but of course it could have been the order in which I did the infusions, so I can't really say which one was better, but I overall seemed to respond better to the Regeneron. After about 4 weeks, which seems to be the pattern, I started to have a little bit of a flare up again in GI symptoms. I didn't really have the night sweats, or I didn't feel like, oh yes, the virus is back. I didn't really feel that. But what I did feel was I just had some like more abdominal cramping and just the digestive issues. So again, I had to be very careful with what I was eating. So I did start to do some intermittent fasting and just eating really, really clean. And it kind of calmed everything back down again. I am right now today, I am at 5 weeks post that infusion. And I would say that right now, like overall, I am generally feeling better, but I know that I have not crossed that line yet, that finish line yet, which we're all like hoping to cross at one point. And that this is just a distant memory, because I did have a flare up of symptoms, but I don't feel that persistent virus feeling that I did feel return after my first infusion. So all I can say is that the needle is being moved. You know, I was way back here and I got up to here with BAM, and then I did get pushed back a little bit. And then I got up here to Regeneron and I got pushed back a little bit. But with each infusion, I have overall noticed an improvement of symptoms and just overall feeling better. So I'm at a point right now where I'm just kind of waiting it out. I'm just going to see how I do. I'm definitely considering another infusion, another dose of Regeneron. But for right now, I haven't really made that decision yet. I'm also looking at a few other treatments, one specifically being EBOO, where they do a cleaning out of your blood and really filter out any like debris and biofilm and toxins and the spike protein. Again, if you're considering a monoclonal infusion, I mean, my personal opinion is that it definitely has helped. I would recommend it, and I will definitely keep you guys posted on how things go over the next few weeks. And again, as always, be well, and I hope on 12/12/22 that this will be a distant memory for me. But until then, I will continue to research and do everything I can to finally get past that finish line. If you've had an infusion or you have any questions about the infusion, please leave a comment below and I will definitely respond to you. And hopefully again, we can all get back to our baseline. So for now, be well.
Can you help me with my diamond? There's a thing inside of it that I need, but make sure to like and subscribe. Thank you.